So the nice thing is I can turn this down at verbatim. So if you guys need me to turn it up, turn it down, I can do that. I'm just testing out all this other stuff before I continue forward. It's not 9:30 just yet, so give me a little bit of time. I'm gonna go through some things. You're live, because I'm live. Yep. I know it's not 9:30. It's not 9:30 yet, but I'm just waiting for a couple people to show up, and then I'm gonna start it. Well, it's... No, you don't have to talk at all. I was just letting you know that I'm online. I was just gonna let you know that, so if you wanted to watch me or something. That's all. I didn't mean... Yeah. Alright, not a problem. You're good. Bye-bye. That was actually Cobra Strike Down when he did have a channel. Nothing dramatic, he just didn't want to do YouTube anymore. But just waiting for a couple more peeps here, just sending out some messages.
Final round.
And let's copy that. Copy. I am struggling like a boomer right now. What the fuck? Why am I having trouble sharing this? This is weird. That's why. Okay. Copy. Send it to my boys. Oh, so.
Round one, fight.
Oh, no, we're good. Alright, is it. Nope, not yet. It is not 9:30 yet. All right.
see what else is here. All right.
But as you can see, what's nice is that Street Fighter EX has a watch mode. So I put random characters in there, and then it plays in all bunch of different angles. It's nice to have that going in the background while I'm setting things up. I can turn the volume up or down if need be. And do I sound okay to anyone who's listening to me? So I think the volume probably being here or here would be good for the gameplay. You guys just let me know. But can you guys hear me just fine? That's what I want to know. And I've got a window to look at the chat here. All right. Thanks, Tony. Got a couple more minutes left. Thank you, Daz. You sound like a man in a beanie wearing glasses. Well, I got it half right. Are you trying to say I sound like a hipster? That's probably right. Welcome, Tweedledee. Not sure who you are, but thanks for stopping by. So thanks. So it's going to be interesting. You know what, I'll start in a second at 9:30, and then we'll go, basically a minute away. Just to give everyone a preface here. Give some people some time to jump in. Maybe I should start at, because I start at 9:30, but maybe I should wait a couple more minutes after that, because I did let everyone at 9:30, and some people are just naturally late to the party. Anyway, guys. What brings you here? Are you excited? I know a couple of you are just pals of mine, and thanks for the support in general. If there's any Mister people out here, anyone who owns one or anything like that, please let me know what you think. I actually jumped on the Mister FPGA group on Facebook. And I got a few likes on there when I said that I was going to live stream it. So I wanted to get that crowd and see if a few of those guys will show up. That's my aim, at least. And anyone who is is just curious about the Mister in general, I'm going to plan on sharing with you what it is and go from there. You're not forced against your will, Cobra Strike Down. Daz, you can do whatever you want. But at least you get to see what's going on with this. I'm pretty excited because I've actually tried out some cores previously to this. And they released PlayStation cores, the nightly builds that are in beta. I couldn't even really play this game. And this was just like a week ago that I tried it, so either I did something wrong or Robert Peep, the guy who made this, works so damn fast that I don't know. The guy is wind. He's just wicked fast. Now my cat's meowing because he's not coming inside. Poor guy. So I'll wait a couple more minutes and then I'll get the show on the road. Thanks to everyone that's shown up so far, too. I appreciate it. Hey, Mr. Tyler is here. Thanks for stopping by. So I'm going to wait a couple more minutes. And to answer you, Daz, Lime Lystra, I think I said that right. He says, it looks great. Is this performance across the board or just specific games? So here's the thing. It's performance across the board, but each game acts differently. I did run into a few that had glitches. So just know that some games are going to work and some are going to work with glitches and some are just not even going to start and some are just going to look like dog shit. Now, I've messed with a few, but then I put a ton more games last night that I haven't tested yet. I mean, I pretty much put all the games that I was interested in and or already sort of tested prior to this. And once I, because this is always my first test game because I love this game, but I was shocked the night and day difference between the previous core update. So this current one just destroys. So let's take a look here. How's the game volume? Is that okay? Up, down? What do you think? In fact, I think I'm gonna put the FPS counter in there just to show everyone. There we go. See it going through 59 to 60. When you see slowdowns, don't worry. I'll explain that as well. Game volume is perfect. Got it. All right, so I think at this point I'm just gonna start, so thanks for stopping by. I know it's not a huge group, but I have five people's attention and they're all people. You're not just numbers, so thanks for stopping by. So I want to talk about something before I continue with the PlayStation stuff in general. The PlayStation Core on the MiSTer. What the hell is the MiSTer? What the hell is all of this in general? So this is the MiSTer, and they just released a, and by they, I mean a developer. Now, what the MiSTer can do is create, the MiSTer can play old school computers, old school video games, things like that, and it's all open source. You might be asking yourself, oh, I've heard of something like this, it's called the Raspberry Pi. Well, the difference between a Raspberry Pi and this is that Raspberry Pi is known as software emulation. Is that terrible? It depends. If software emulation isn't optimized properly, I know that input latency can suffer. But even at its peak, there will always be some form of input latency. Is it something that can fuck up your entire game? I disagree. There's a lot of people out there that they want it to be legit or get the fuck out. And, you know, honestly, there's some delays that we can sort of adapt to. Like, let's say you press A to jump, and it takes a whole 5 seconds to do that action. Okay, there's something clearly wrong with that input latency. That's, like, unplayable at that point. But if you press it and you can't really feel anything, then it's probably fine. Now, if you're accustomed to a game that you've played your whole life, and you press A and it doesn't jump in the way that you remember. I feel like those are the very rare circumstances where you can see that kind of input latency. But other than that, the Raspberry Pis or anything like that, the single board computers, is a decent alternative to all this emulation for old school stuff. That being said, if you want something that plays it input latency like accurate, like cycle accurate, you might want to be you might be interested in the MiSTer. There's another side to that story due to price and chip shortages, unfortunately, but that aside, the point is that what does this do compared to a Raspberry Pi? It is cycle accurate emulation. That is what FPGA is. I think it's like, I forgot what the F stands for. It's like gate array. I can't. Field programmable gate array. I think that's. Do I know what that means? No, but I know the anagram. Point is, it's hardware emulation. it emulates the console or computer specifically, so it'll act just like that. It'll act just like the console. Now, what's the big deal? You know, we've had PlayStation emulation, Super Nintendo emulation, Nintendo emulation for years. What makes this special? Again, obviously the latency and stuff like that, but developing for something like this is a bit more challenging, from what I am told. I'm not going to pretend to be an expert on this stuff. I'm just talking to you what I've gathered about this device. I have actually a question from Tony here. He says, is a MiSTer a good option for an arcade cabinet build like the one behind you, or is it an emulator PC better like the one that I have? So Tony knows me personally. In that arcade cabinet, I made that bar top arcade cabinet. I use a PC for that. I currently use that because I think it's cheap and affordable, and it gets the job done. I don't want people to think that software emulation is dog shit and has no value. It certainly does. I mean, there would be so many games lost without emulation. Hardware emulation is just a bit more accurate when it comes to input latency. And there's probably some other things that I'm not thinking of that has benefits. And on that, there's a vendor known as MiSTer Add-ons. He developed the MiSTer, the MiSTercade. You can literally put that in JAMA boards, like actual arcade cabinets. So instead of collecting, 10 arcade cabinets of your favorite games, perhaps those games are emulated through the MiSTer and already compatible. And if that's the case, you have one arcade cabinet with multiple games, without having to have a fucking storage unit full of arcade games. You can just have all of it on one device, on one arcade cabinet. And you can easily put that in something if you've got a basement or a huge space or something like that. Your guy room or something like that. Anyway, I hope that answers your question in some way, Tony. I like my current build. I have no reason to put in MiSTer in it right now. But I thought down the line maybe I'll have a real arcade cabinet and get something like the MiSTer Arcade in the future. Anyway, so this is the first time that 3D games have been implemented into the MiSTer. Previously, there was another guy working on the PlayStation Core. I think his name was Laxar, but he had a partner. Apparently, they had a falling out. And because they had a falling out, the project kind of ceased. Over time, Robert Peep, this is where he comes in. You see the little guy on the icon here, down below here. He has worked on MiSTer Cores in the past. And so he decides to jump in into this, and not only did he develop this core, he added save states to it as well. And that's great, because there's parts where sometimes the things, the game can freeze. But if you have a save state, you can leave off there and try to work around that, because sometimes it's hit and miss. But point is Robert Peep picked this up and started working on it, and you can donate to his Patreon. I became a Patreon to him, and the reason I did, I don't know, I just wanted to see it. I just wanted to see it really badly. The guy works like fucking lightning. I mean, just wicked fast. What took the previous guys a while just for minimal progress, and I don't mean to... I don't mean to slander the guy, or I'm not slandering. I don't mean to make fun of the guy or downplay his achievements, because this is all really hard work. But no one can deny that Robert Peet's speed on this is insane. So, this started about a few months ago, and we're already here. So, again, I should probably jump into this. Let me answer a couple questions here. Someone asks, is this Mortal Kombat? No, this is Street Fighter EX. This is one of my, favorite Street Fighter games. It's the first 3D one. For the first one, they did a pretty damn good job. As Tyler says, Dova Keech, always appreciate the addition of save states. Same. It's actually funny that Robert Peep added save states to the PSX core, the PlayStation core. Because there's some cores like the Super Nintendo and the Genesis, at least from last time I checked, they don't have that. That would be very useful when you're playing shit like Earthbound or all these JRPGs. So I hope at one point someone will add that to it. I'm sure they will. But anyway, why don't we jump into this, shall we? So if you guys have any questions, please throw it out here. Also, I want to show you something. I want to show you my game list. I have a ton of games on here. This isn't a flex. I purposely did this. So if any of you have any requests, you want Crash Bandicoot, you want Spyro, you want Ridge Racer, I'll throw it on there. And I haven't tested all of these. You want Crash Team Racing? I got that. I've got Gex, I've got Ghost in the Shell, Legend of Dragoon, Parasite Eve, Saga Frontier 2. I've got all these other things that I haven't tried yet. So please, if there's a game you want me to test out, I'll do it. But first things first, I want to show you this this build of Street Fighter EX. Or not this build, but I want to show you how its compatibility is. So let's get started here. All right. So I want you to, I'm actually going to go to the expert mode because that's one of my favorite things to do. Watch, I'm going to choke in front of everyone. So I can definitely do rival schools, Lime Lystra. I can definitely do that. So with Guile, these trials, there's a certain moment that I want to show you something with the frames. You'll see what I mean. So, all right. So here's Sonic Boom. Flash Kick. And notice that, like, everything is running pretty well. So everything's running pretty well here. Now, I tried this previously last week with a different core update. And when Ken was doing his Shoryuken, it had particle effects. And when there was particle effects, it slowed down. It was playable, but slowed down. That is not an issue anymore. This game is damn near perfect, at least with Street Fighter EX. Now, there's some times where the music cuts out and sometimes it freezes during the watch mode. Other than that, it's been a solid experience. I completed the arcade mode in one playthrough. So let's continue here. All right, crouching like punch. And whoops, that was the wrong one. All right. So, notice it slowed down when it said complete. Not a big deal. And I'll tell you why. It's like, oh, there was a slowdown. There needs to be work on the core. Yes, there needs to be work on the core. But that slowdown isn't actually, like, a core problem. It's actually programmed to do that. Here's why I know. If you guys can't tell, I've been playing this game for a while. If you see me get through these trials. Every time a complete comes up, or when you complete the mission on this, the original PlayStation game slowed down like that. What is my point? My point is that the Mister is accurately representing the PlayStation the way it was. That's why you see slowdown every time you see complete, because that's what it originally did in the original game back in the 90s. So here we go. Michael Hockey, one of your favorite games. Thanks, dude. You know, I never hear that, so makes me happy that you agree. So this game is stellar. Whoops, forgot a trick. There we go. I'm kind of nervous doing in front of everyone. So there's a certain part where I just stop with Guile, and I'd keep on going, but I don't think you guys want to see me struggle with the other ones. I'll do one more character, and then we'll move on to another game. Let's do
maybe Ken or something. All right, we got 8 viewers. Welcome, everyone. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate that. So, do a couple of that. Whoops. So I was saying that with the particle effects, it used to slow down. Not anymore, as you can see. Oh, also, if you haven't noticed, this is what I'm using. I'm using an 8-bit DOE controller. I modded it with this joystick and these buttons, but you've probably seen them. It looks like a Famicom. It had red buttons and the black ball. So I never was able to play this game with an arcade stick because it was obviously locked to the PlayStation controller right here. Hopefully you can see that. This is the PlayStation Classic controller, which has a USB hub. I'll probably put that in eventually, but when I'm playing something like this, I like to have an arcade stick. So I gotta say, although I love the game and I played it on this natively as a kid, I do enjoy having this on the arcade stick. It just feels natural. Dova Keech says, loved my original Street Fighter EX video. Thanks, pal. That was like 3 years ago. If anyone is interested in that stuff, please check out my channel. I actually have videos where I edit and put a lot of effort and time into it. I know I'm a small channel, but I'd like to change that. I've had friends tell me that they don't understand why I don't have more viewers, and they're not just saying that to impress me. This is what they genuinely mean. I've had strangers come up randomly seeing my stuff, saying the same thing. I could tell you why. I'm not as consistent, but I'd like to change that this year. And then also, marketing for yourself is tough, guys. So that's why I was reaching out to the Mr. Crowd and everything, and I hope you guys enjoy this stuff. So, because what I offer is basically video game content. Whoops, that was the wrong one. It was the medium kick. There we go. I was just being a show-off by adding that trick. Anyway, you guys get the point. So, let's try a different game. Just go based on Lime Leister's suggestion. We're going to do Rival Schools. And I did catch you. Who was the guy? He said Metal Gear Solid. I did catch you, Tweedledee. I will put that on as well. So, we'll start out with Rival Schools. Fighting games are really easy to jump into. So that's why I that's why I'd also like to start with that one too. I can't read, I guess. Rival Schools had 2 different discs. It's like one of the one of the few fighting games that has 2 discs. So notice I select a game and it didn't immediately do it. That's because you have to reset it. It literally is acting like if you had this game running on your PlayStation, you would like when you're swapping a disc, so let's say the power's on and you hit the open button and then you take out the Street Fighter EX disc and then you put in Rival Schools, you're still going to get this image. So it's acting like that. So again, it's acting like it's the PlayStation. And then Michael Hockey says, or it's Hokey, excuse me, probably Hockey, why am I called CatPat? I'm called CatPat because I've got 2 cats. They're pretty cool. I always had an affinity for my my cats in general. But my name's Patrick as well, so that's why I go by CatPat. But yeah, that's why. It's not related to video games, I guess, but it just stuck. It's quick. It's easy. Go from there. Anyway, let's reset this and put Rival Schools up here. All right. So that's the thing. I don't think I configured the memory card on this, but that's okay because we have save states and I can do that another time. So you can tell, notice the FPS is 15. That's just because that's the frame rate for these full motion videos. And you will notice, wow, does that quality look like dog shit? You'd be right. And that's not the core's fault. That's just because that's the quality of the videos for the PlayStation at the time. It gets nicer looking when the actual graphical engine comes in. So I'm going to skip that. Turn up the volume a little bit. I don't know. Let's try Kiyosuke and Knife Boy. Now, I'm not a pro at rival schools. I know some tricks. There was like that. Yeah, I remember that one. Okay. So, Lime Lystra, you've played this game. Is it looking good so far? Now, I've played this game in the past too, but I don't know. You know, I don't know it like I know Street Fighter EX. I'm gonna turn that down a little bit. Alright, he says he's a pro, he shall judge. And I remember there's like combos you can do. I don't like this auto-guarding shit though. I wonder if I can change that. Guard off. Yes. I turned guard off. What is this? Okay. It just ignores my commands, I guess. There we go. Alright, so I know that one. And I think there's like a combo attack you can do with your pails. Yeah. Okay, well, Lime Lystra says that as a, someone who's played this game for a while, it's emulated pretty well. You know, let's try other things too. Let's go to like the actual arcade mode here. She is well endowed. let's see. Sure, let's go with Batu. I don't really know too many of these characters, to be honest, so I'm just skipping ahead here. Graphics look perfect. Great. I don't know what happened. I had a few viewers and then they just bounced, but that's all right. Anyway, if you can't tell, I'm not a pro at this game. But I think that is good for rival schools. Let me try something else. Let's go to Metal Gear Solid. Now, I'm not going to go too crazy with that one, but we can at least watch the intro and discuss some stuff as that's going on. And let's restart. But yeah, cool. So that was, yeah. Lime Lyster says the game's perfect so far, my skills not so much. Don't need to rub it in, come on. It's got the music. Oh, I don't know if I want to play Metal Gear Solid on my arcade stick, so let's swap it out, shall we? So we're going to go with that guy. All right. Again, guys, please request some games. I just want people to know you, that is a possibility. That is something you can do.
The nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Colonel. Forces, being led by members of Foxhound.
But you guys have any questions, let me know. You know, and I can adjust and take that FPS counter off. I'm going to do that now, actually. It's a go. They'll launch a nuclear weapon. I think I hit this button. And let's go to FPS. Whoops, you'll have that's two not what mission objectives. Oh, I think my buttons are all fucked up on this. Donald Anders. So let's change that. Let's go to. Oh, and the president of arms. Oh, wait a minute. Kenneth Baker.
Both are being held as hostages.
Right, left, down, secondly, up. Trying to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the select start L1 R1 L2 R2. I don't have analog sticks, so we're just gonna hit enter to finish.
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
There we go. Do I have scan lines on this, or is that part of the? That might be part of just the thing. After the SDV gets as close as it can. Oh yeah, no problem, Tweedledee. Not a problem at all. Thought I turned that FPS off though. Or maybe I turned fast food off.
High-tech Special Forces Unit Foxhound. Your former unit, and one that I was a commander
There we
of.
Go. Get out
so
of here.
So they're still around.
There are six members of Foxhound involved in this
Yeah, is there online
terror.
Multiplayer? Yeah, Oh, I don't know if you're being sarcastic or not. No, there is not. The MiSTer pretty Decoy much just Octopus, emulates Master of Disguise, Raven, Giant, and Shaman. The console specifically. And that would be nice, though. Interrogation, and a formidable gunfighter. And finally, you said they don't make them like they used to. Yeah, that's a. I can agree and disagree with that. I mean, I definitely side with you more on that one. It's just. I think it's just that. Games aren't tailored for our demographic anymore. Games do feel differently back then. Is it locked to 30 FPS? It's locked to whatever game, like Street Fighter EX that I played earlier. That's a 60 FPS game. Just because this isn't 30 FPS doesn't mean just because this is 30 FPS doesn't mean it's not running the way it was originally running previously. Now maybe there'll be a thing. Or an update, Robert will add to this that gives it the option to run at 60 FPS, but I have a feeling it's just going to run just like a PlayStation game. So far, the icons look good. I forgot it's one of those games you have to press circle instead of X. No. Okay. But, No, I definitely enjoy my classic games, but they have some good ones still. As Lime Leister said, Windjammers 2 fucking rules. Me and my friends will play that and scream at each other like hyenas. Oh, no problem, man. You got to see what you want. You got what you wanted out of it. Not a problem. Just make sure you like the video and stop by another time and check out my channel. Have an excellent day, man. But that being said, we could probably move on to a different game. So, but from what I'm seeing, this is my first time testing it. Everything looks good. Sounds good, too. So that's great. We're going to move on to another one. All right. Let's try. Well, let's just ask. Whoever's here can pick the game. That's probably going to be Lime Leistra, so go ahead. So I'll go through my catalog here and you can find something. Got Alundra, Bloody Bride. I have Bloody Roar 2. I know that's... You know what? Let's try Bloody Roar 2 because I think Lime Leistra enjoys that one quite a bit. Whoops. Now let's reset it. Can you test Final Fantasy VII and Crash Bandicoot Team Racing? I can do that too. We'll throw in some Bloody Roar 2, because I know you like that game, and also this is one of the harder to emulate games. So I think a few people will appreciate that. Here's a shitty FMV.
Bloody Roar 2, the new breed.
This always threw me off, like, when I was younger. I never thought this had a practice mode, but basically you just go to custom and then go to practice. I wasn't the smartest kid. And I always liked the bat chick. I don't remember all the tricks or anything, though.
Jenny, the bat.
Can you guys guess why I like the bat chick? Please, just guess. I'm sure you can't. So, something I did notice too, and a couple games have this. Notice her legs when she's walking. There's like these lines here. So I don't think this is perfect. It could be the way the game's developed. It could be programmed. Because I did notice in the options, like, you can turn dithering on and off. And I don't think that's dithering, but I think they have de-interlacing as well. So it could be a few things that still needs work, but otherwise, I mean, I'm playing it. It's working. And let's see, I think, yeah, we can do her special here. I was also surprised there's like moves in this game that's kind of bloody. I didn't actually get to play this one as a kid. It wasn't until I was much older. It's also one of those games that's kind of interesting too, because like it has some combos and then some slide moves like Street Fighter with the arrow button combinations. I'm gonna turn this down though. The music's like jamming out like it's a blues fest or something. But says that's the in the game and in emulation. Limeister says I don't know if you mean the blur with the legs and everything. Because then that would tell me that this is fine. I don't think I've saw that in emulation, but to be honest, I don't emulate this game quite a bit, so I could totally be fucking wrong. So, moving on. You wanted to see Final Fantasy VII and Crash Team Racing. So I did try Crash Team Racing, at least to the logo, and I'll show you one thing with that that's a little funny. It's not awful. Definitely it will be fixed over time. Reset. The leg dithering. So that did happen. Okay, well, that's good to know. I wonder if Duck Station, that software emulation, can fix that. Or has fixed that. I'm sure it has if I tried it out. Makes me appreciate Street Fighter EX more and more, though, because that game's just purely just like 60 FPS and just blocks, and there's nothing, there's no video tricks to hide its imperfections with the CRT television. It's just, you get what you get is what you see. What you see is what you get. I think that's that. I don't know how to fucking talk, apparently. So, it's not doing it now. Maybe it'll do it here. Huh. The flag had some weird lines at one point. They're not really there anymore. So I wonder... It could just act randomly. But, let's go to adventure then. Seems to be a little bit slow there. Saw a little bit of screen tearing there. As you're changing the characters. Nothing crazy though, of course. I used to like Tiny quite a bit. Tiny the Tiger. I liked Tiny and I liked Crash. This turn is dog shit though. I'll just go with Normie. Let's be just 12. How about ball? the... Jeez, holy shit. There we go. Okay, there we go. JQ the King. Hi, Pat. Hello. I think that's one of my personal friends, so thanks for stopping by.
Welcome to the Adventure Arena.
I just don't know his username.
You can travel around this area and practice your driving skills.
So, again, for anyone that's joining in, whoever knows things about the MiSTer or all that stuff, what makes this significant, this is the first 3D core that's supported on the MiSTer. We've got another guy working on Sega Saturn that's going at a good pace, but the PlayStation core specifically has been astronomically fast. Again, what makes this significant is that the MiSTer has cycle accurate emulation. What that means is there's going to be very low latency inputs. So software emulation, although damn good and I very much love it, I probably play it more than the hardware emulation. And that's just because of all the features that it has. It's all good stuff. But this is kind of what the MiSTer is one of those things that it emulates hardware. And it's trying, excuse me, I think a lot of people are saying it's going to be the future of emulation just because of how accurate it is. And so far, it's playing really well. Hello. We're live. What can I do for you? Here comes Alicia, my girlfriend. She's going to say some naughty things. She has a foul mouth, trust me. She's the worst girlfriend ever, and she beats me. You can't see the bruises because they're underneath my shirt. Yeah. Well, too bad for you. I'm streaming online.
Oh no! I'll do it on camera.
No. See, if you do it on camera, the evidence is there. That's foolish. What do you mean no one would? What do you? What do you mean no one would believe? It's literally on footage of you beating me. When I took a bat and beat your head in, it was just a joke.
It's just a prank, bro.
It's just a prank. It's YouTube. It's a satire video, okay? Everything's fine. You can do anything you want on YouTube as long as you say it's satire.
Oh, his face is the best.
Yeah, thank you. Tony says hi. That's the consequence of being in first place, is that every fucking target is on you. But yeah, so far, this is looking good. Again, this is a game I played as a kid, but I don't know if there's like any other weird graphical things going on that's missing. But from what I can tell, it looks really good. Oh yeah, Daz says he doesn't believe in video evidence, so if he says so, just, yeah, I guess you can beat me anywhere. You're scot-free. Yeah, that never happens, ever. Tyler's on here. He says deep fake. You'd never do that. JQ the King says, I think the console wars doesn't matter. Xbox only cares about Game Pass. Yeah, Game Pass is definitely interesting. Me and Lime Leister were talking about that the other day. The concept of, like renting everything. That's basically what it is. I mean, that's what Netflix is. It's just, you know, renting these movies occasionally, and they can take them away at any time. And, you know, it's cool. I think it's a great, like, I'm not going to discount all of these streaming services and all of these, like, you know, renting services like Game Pass and Netflix. I think it's good for you to test out games that you might want to purchase. And sometimes you're not that committed to games and to certain games you complete. So I think it's a good way to try out games. Just know that since it's not something you own, they can be taken away at any time. So that's why people like their physical media. Or you make digital backups and you can play your old games on the MiSTer or Raspberry Pis and things like that. So I just played a level of Crash Bandicoot. I think that is good enough for testing on that. I didn't see any hiccups. Thank you. I meant to drink this. That. I will do that in a second. But so we're going to move on to another one. I think Daz, a.k.a. Lime Lyster, wanted to try out Final Fantasy VII. You guys, throw something out there. Tony, I know you enjoy Soul Blade. We'll test that one out, too. So we'll do that. Final Fantasy VII.
What
so,
about Soul Edge?
I think that's the same game, actually. It's, like, named Soul Edge in, like, the UK, and it's called Soul Blade here, or it's reverse. Weird. Oh, yeah, it's definitely odd. But
I want to see that opening.
Yeah, it's probably one of the best Soul Calibur openings ever. So this version of the Final Fantasy game that I have here, we
the
had
game
some.
Says play Pokemon Blue. Big
I can play Pokemon Blue, but it's not on my Mister right now, and it's not a PlayStation. Get with the program, dude. Also, JQ the King, you spelled Alicia wrong. You can see her face just turning all red. She's so angry right now. Yeah. Yep.
Oh.
Well.
It's ALICIA because I'm in the CIA.
Okay. You know, that is actually much better. Not cold.
Really?
Yeah. Warm? So, this is Pigeon Hill oatmeal cream pie. Stout. I am not a big beer fan, but this is one I can drink. I think this is a Midwest brew, though.
Yeah, I think Pigeon Hill is by
I'm not sponsored by Pigeon Hill, by the way.
Still good, though.
He says sorry if he spelled your name wrong.
It's okay. Everyone spells it wrong.
Yeah, so this version of Final Fantasy VII, thank the ROM hacking community. They changed the font here to look like the original Final Fantasy font in like 1 through 6. And then they also... retranslated it because there was a lot of spelling errors in the original version of it. Also, they like there's parts in the game where it says press the action button to do this action. This will just tell you the icon. It'll just say press the circle icon to do this. So it's all these life improvements that are really neat. So Dane, just to keep you up to date. So what's making this stream important is this is the first 3D implementation to come out on the Mister. I know we've all played PlayStation. I know that you can emulate PlayStation everywhere, but what makes us special is because it's going to be lag-free, input-free on the Mister device specifically. Actually, for anyone who knows what I'm talking about with some of this retro stuff, I wanted to say I actually own a PlayStation 1. And I planned it on modding it with the HDMI mod. Now, my friends know that I've done the mod on the Dreamcast. And the same guy made a HDMI chip for the PlayStation. So I was ready to do that. Sold out. Everywhere. Everywhere. And because of the chip shortage, I can't do it. They haven't made any since then. I know you're kidding, Dave. But I haven't been able to do it since then. I think it's been like 2-3 years now. Maybe two, probably. Probably two. I don't want to be hyperbolic. Just because they don't have parts anymore. And if there is, they're on eBay and it's $350. And I'm not going to do that. So, what makes this great is that having this on the Mister as an HD solution at 1080p, that solves my problem. However, there's a current problem with the Mister, not with the hardware specifically. It's that just like most tech right now, the board that runs the Mister, the DE10 Nano...
Oh.
Excuse me, Jesus Christ. The DE10 Nano board that runs the Mister is sold out, like, everywhere. And unless you want to pay $425, $50 on eBay, you're fucked. So, you know, I have a feeling... That's another thing, too. I'm going off so many tangents. So, yeah, parts are limited for the Mister right now, but I have a feeling they'll come back a lot quicker than Black Dog Tech's HDMI mod for the PlayStation. But because there's a lot of people that use DE10 Nano boards, not just for emulation, but for other tech projects. So I'm sure it'll be around. Maybe I'll eat my words. But anyway, so you're starting to see some of these differences in this version of the game. when I picked up the potion from that guy, I noticed it said picked up potion, but the potion was like in blue font. It what it's trying to do is like show what it's trying to extenuate, and it even has a little icon of the satchel too. It's trying to extenuate that you picked up an item. It's not just all white font. And it does look... oh, thank you. Yeah, I don't know what you said is seamless, Dane, but if you mean the games and stuff, yeah, it does. If you mean, like, the update for this game specifically, the hack, for sure. And that's another thing they changed, too. Originally, where it says Biggs, it would have been white. And I like that it's yellow, so that signifies that this is the character that's talking. I know, like, people aren't idiots and they can gather that overall, but it, like, makes it more seamless to separate what they're saying to who they are. So little changes like that really makes a difference. But again, the music is fucking banging. And that was one of the recent things that Robert Peep updated in his core. Oh, this is good. Sure. All right. So what I want to do is get to a part to show you what I meant by the, like, press the action button to do this or something. I think I got to that at one point. The yellow signifies he's gonna die, yes. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so anytime anyone talks, it's just like him and Eris. Alright, so I'm just trying to get through this as quick as possible. Then we're going to move on to a different game here. Probably Soul Blade for Tony. So again, guys, whatever you want, throw in the comments and I'll throw it up. And so Dovakich says he digs the text changes. Yeah, it's these small little subtleties that actually just make the game, I don't know, smoother. And I dig the font change too. It just looks like it always belonged. Do I have a trick? Yeah, I do. Here you go, thunder. Just to switch it up here. All right. Is Army Men or Roll Cage on there? So, Tony says. I'm sorry, Tony. I don't play dog shit. No, I'm just kidding. It is not on there. I'm so sorry. I did get a lot of games on here, though. So odds are it'll be on there. It just happens that those two that you want aren't on there. So I apologize. Anyway, I don't know if I need to get to that point, but, like, where it shows to press circle to do this. You guys get it. But, yeah, these little subtle changes are nice. So, that being said, the music sounds good. No graphical glitches so far. It's like, Jesus Christ. It's just good job so far. So, next one up is Soul Blade. If I can read. There we go. Nope. Okay, let's try that again. Shit. Oh, that's right. I did press it. I just have to hit the reset. There we go. Wipeout XL can be tricky to emulate. Man, I wish I knew that. I have Wipeout 3 on here, though. See, there's like certain games that I know the franchise series on there, but like I'll pick the better one to try out. Like, what's a good example? Like, I have Bloody Roar 2, but I don't have Bloody Roar 1. On here. Let's take a second, though, to fucking jam out to one of the best intros in fighting game history. I'm gonna turn that shit up. To thank me later. As you can see, just everything is running so well so far. In fact, we haven't come across a game with too many problems yet. I can show you a couple. They do exist. But so far, it's good stuff.
Hey,
Sorry, Lion Lystra says the better one. Oh shit terms fighting. Shit. Shit them. Oh shit, those are fighting words. Got it. No, I did not mean to imply that the second one is better than the first one. It's just like that kind of assumption. It's just like based on what people are saying, that is the better one, so I try that. Something like that. I don't know why this song is so good. like, there's no Soul Calibur that has, like, even came close to such a powerful intro. You know, when you're a kid, and maybe not even a kid, sometimes then as an adult even. I mean, I just fucking did it. But basically, like, you start up a game and, like, they have, like, intros. But you let the intro play out every time you start the game because it just gets you pumped up to do it. It just gets you pumped up to play the game. This is one of those games. So, excuse me. All right. So, we'll just go to arcade. We'll see if there's any weird glitches. I do notice the character icons are really blurry unless they're selected, but that could be the way the game's designed. We'll go with Siegfried, aka used to be Nightmare, or becomes Nightmare later. Oh, there we go. It says E2 right there. The E stands for error, so we came across an error. Let's try that again. Maybe I can bypass that with the save state. So as you can see, nothing is perfect here. So we'll try that again. And maybe I can go to practice or something. We'll see. And now I'm going to do a save state. Just so in case that happens and we don't have to go through that stuff again.
Welcome to the stage of history.
Nope. Error. Yeah. So I don't think this one's going to play. Okay, well, that's our first game out of, like, what, 5 so far? That's fucked up. Not bad. Not bad for a beta core. So, let's continue. I don't know if I want my beer next to all of my electronics over there. So, let me go through what people have suggested. We went through a few of these games. Okay, well, I think I've covered the games that people suggested. Anyone who wants to make a suggestion what game to try out next, throw it out there. I'll do it. So I want to show you a game in the meantime. It was a game I played as a kid, and I totally forgot about it until, like, 2 years ago. And it's aged pretty good, pretty well, other than, again, the FMV cutscenes. But I don't know if anyone remembers this game. What is it called? Motor Tune Grand Prix. Graphically, it's very inspired. It's very cartoony, as you would imagine. Like, it's got that, like, Roger Rabbit shit going on. I do not have Blast Radius, Lime Lystra. I apologize. Wipeout 3. I'll try Wipeout 3 next. But, yeah, so... this game was a lot of fun. You get your creepy FMVs with the really shitty-looking... character designs, so that's just the PlayStation, unfortunately. But I like the way the cars, like, morph diagonally as if they're, like, a breathing, living thing.
I'm just gonna get to the gameplay here. So, yeah, we'll just go here. The money signs lets you pick up. Notice it says coin up here. What that stands for is a roulette wheel, and then you press circle again, and that's the item you get to use against other people. So let's use it. So it slows down some people. And that's, I forget about the drift button. The drift button, I'm so accustomed to using it on the triggers, but it's like the square button in this time, in this game. This is before they've really honed driver games the way they are. Let's see what I get this time. I don't know what this does. It probably goes behind me, yep. The Mario Kart banana peel, so to speak. Alright, let's grab one of these guys. You can just collect a fuck ton of these, too. Oil can. Yeah, that's basically another Mario banana peel. Hydro Thunder. I don't think I have that on this one. So, like, I know, like, Street Fighter Street Fighter Alpha and Marvel vs. Capcom and a couple other Capcom fighters, like Marvel vs. Street Fighter, is on the PlayStation, and I didn't put them on there. And you may be asking, or saying, oh, that's blasphemous, why wouldn't you do that? That's because this is the MiSTer, and I have the native CPS2 cores, like the actual arcade games, already on it. And it runs better as on that than the PlayStation port of those games. So, what place am I in? Oh, I'm in first. Great. I think you guys get the point of this one. It's a goofy, fun one. So, we'll try out Wipeout 3. Again, thanks everyone for stopping by. Appreciate it. And if you have any other questions, it doesn't have to be MiSTer related, about literally anything, please throw it through. Throw it my way. I'm willing to talk about anything. And again, just as the icons say at the bottom of my video here, if you like what you see, donate to Robert Peep. I mean, What he's doing with this core is insane. At the speed that he's developing this compatibility to the MiSTer is absolutely insane. I'm going to skip this. One thing that I really like about Wipeout is the UI in the presentation. What's my SS number? Yeah, I don't know if I can answer that one. Dane says Tony Hawk Pro Skater. Dane, I can do that. However, I'm debating if I should turn off the music in that game or not. And you may be asking, why would I turn off the music? It's because they're licensed tracks, and I could get demonetized for that or copyright claimed. But in all fairness, I'm not making a fucking amount, like a penny off the shit anyway right now, so maybe it doesn't matter. But I'll be able to turn the music off in that anyway. Wipeout's looking great on this, holy shit. I also have Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 on this as well. Oh, something's slowing me down. Truth be told, I have not really played too many. I think the last Wipeout game I played was on the PS3,
And I didn't play too much Wipeout in general. It's a nice looking game though. See, futuristic games do really well on like low polygon kind of devices like the PlayStation or Sega Saturn or even the PS2, because it all looks robotic and futuristic anyway, so I think it blends really well. Cool. First place. I'm only here for the Tony Hawk music. Well, fine. I'll put the fucking music on. God damn. You guys just don't want me to make any money. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I can do that. In fact, I'll do it right now. Oh, man. But yeah, the Tony Hawk soundtrack does indeed slap, as the kids say. I have to say that because I'm 29. Breaks my heart, but that's where I'm at. It really isn't that big of a deal. But yeah, I think I played a stage or two. I played the first stage on this, testing it out last night, actually. Does pretty well. Always go for loose. At least I feel that way. I know tight makes it the skateboard go faster, but I always like loose trucks in this game. See if I remember anything on this. I used to be able to like get all the achievements in one go. I don't know if I can do that anymore. Let's see if I can't get the tape. Missed it. Oh man, I'm fucking it up. Can I get the entirety of Skate and the boxes in one go? Let's find out. The T's over there, so I need to go over here. There we go. And the box. Shit. There we go. And then there's one over here. Okay. And let's see if I can't get the tape in the last 24 seconds. Hey! There's no way I'm gonna land that. Ah! I was trying to do the 900. Okay, so Tyler says, that's all five. Holy shit. I unlocked two levels in that one run. Hell yeah. Dova Keech says that he wished they remade the Underground games. I know that they made Tony Hawk 1 and 2 remastered. It was pretty good, so I think they went in the right direction with that. Dova Keech also says it looks like this is running great. I'm glad. Yeah, I haven't encountered any glitches in that so far. I should go to the next stage and see if it's there. Let's take a look here.
Let's see if any other stages are fucked up looking. But so far, again, there was really one game that failed to work with us. I know that Rayman doesn't work right now. It pauses after it has the Ubisoft screen on it. Shit. Gotta retry. Then he needs... But, yeah, other than that. Oh, shit. I don't like that. I like the bowl over here. That's my favorite part. But, yeah, geez, like, so far. Oh, man, even, did you see, you can even see the video right there on the projector. It's playing stuff. I mean, so far, this has been good. I'm kind of just... Like, I know everyone's saying, like, oh, it's not playable right now. It's like, are you fucking sure? Like, some games, yeah, obviously, but, like, some of these are just running perfectly. Or, okay, I'm being hyperbolic. There's probably some things that prohibit it from being perfect, but a lot of it is just functional. It's insane. Okay, what's next? So, again, let's go through the list here, actually. Now, I know I tried Advanced VG, too. That's like a fighting game in Japan. I tried it yesterday. It's a fighting game. It's all chicks. Definitely weeaboo stuff. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Alundra, that's like the dark fantasy Legend of Zelda, more or less. Last time I tried the core, actually, it froze on when I went inside of a room. But that's before I updated it. So let's see if that's fixed. Here's a question, guys. What is a retro game that you played a lot in the past? Or how about a retro game in general, like that you have the most fondest memories of? It doesn't have to be a game. You can list a couple, of course. Throw that in the comments there. In the chat, and maybe we can discuss. Okay, so let's give this a shot. Oh, by the way, if you saw the Alundra with its FMV looking like poopy, again, that's just how it was back then. The FMVs were like either 5 FPS or 15. Like, they're either really bad or sort of okay. And this is one of the games where the pixel art is so detailed. I really enjoyed this one. So, I remember, what did this guy say? I'm returning to my beloved. I've nearly forgotten how it feels to hold her in my arms. And what of you? Why do you travel to Torla? What, your dreams led you to the ship? You ain't one of them freak boys, are you? What does that mean? I don't know what that means. What? I wonder if, like, that was, like, in Japan, it was, like, something worse, and then they had to localize it to freak boys, like he called them gay or something. That would be amazing. You're not one of those funny fellas, are you? So this is actually what I was talking about. I went into this room and it froze. It's fine now, since this core update. Like I said, I mean, like, there's just been a lot of improvements just literally within the week I've had this core update. This is insane. But it's all here. So something else I would like to discuss as well, as I'm going through some of these games, is that, as some of you people know, I had Polymega content consistently, And I think people were confused because although I did like the Polymega and I covered that extensively, I also wanted to have a MiSTer so I could have something to compare it to. Geez, I'm so bad at... Let me select the game and then I'll go back to what I was saying. Let's try... About like one of the Mega Man games. No, I don't want to do that. I want something more 3D like. Yeah, we could get the Tekken 2 going on. Okay, so the funny thing about the MiSTer is I sort of saw it around, but it wasn't really until I had the Polymega that I actually found out or knew more about the MiSTer. And that's because, which is inevitable when you like anything, there's always someone's like, well, the alternative is this, and if you don't like it, you're a retard. And it's like, okay, calm down, buddy. But once I found out about the MiSTer, I was intrigued. But there's no way anyone could have convinced me to buy a MiSTer in 2018 or maybe 2017. I'm not sure. It was the year when they just released the Sega Genesis Core. They had NES and old computers and stuff like that, like Apple II and all that kind of shit. I think eventually there's CPS 1, Capcom arcade games. But there's no way anyone could have convinced me to get that at that time, because although those are cool, it's not enough consoles that I personally like for me to justify to get that. But once they added Neo Geo and Super Nintendo, and they were working on the CPS2 Capcom arcade games, I raised an eyebrow. I was like, okay, now I could get into that. So I think that was around 2019. Now, I had pre-ordered the Polymega, and I was very excited for that. And I know the differences. It's not software emulation and all that kind of stuff, but it has a really nice UI, looks good. I thought the module concept was interesting. But two things happened. One is I was tired of waiting, and I know that's what everyone says, but more specifically, I became more minimalistic with collecting. I really don't think I need to own certain games that don't hit me right. So buying a bunch of shit and having it cluttered on your shelf or in a box somewhere just didn't seem appealing to me anymore. So that doesn't mean I got rid of all my gaming stuff. Trust me, I have some gaming stuff, but it's the stuff that means the most to me. I made a whole video about that concept, so if you're interested, go ahead and check out the video. It was called Selective Gaming. But that being said, I canceled my pre-order for the Polymega, and this isn't a story where I'm like, yeah, I'm on Team MiSTer now, and I'm not like a grifter. I would have appreciated both of them, and in fact, I know people that have both of them, and they enjoy them very much for different reasons, and that's completely justifiable. But there's something I just need to get out of the way for people. And yes, Tony, I love the opening to Tekken 2 as well. The music is great. But there's something that I need to get out of the way about the MiSTer that I think people need to understand. There's people that are like, oh, why don't you get the MiSTer? You know, it's no latency and all that kind of stuff. It's like, for the people that are interested in the Polymega, they don't want to set things up. Some people are not tech-oriented. You could say, well, that's not that hard. And it's like, okay, I understand, but some people don't want to do any work of it whatsoever. Oh, they're lazy. No, they just don't have the interest. They don't want a project. They just want to do, you know, I know there's things that make setup for the MiSTer easier. As for me, I'm naturally a techie. That arcade back there, I built myself. So, although I think the MiSTer is fantastic, you could call it a tinker toy. Now, is it simplified? Yes. But it doesn't have, it's not like it has the UI the Polymega does. And I'm not saying that, again, to side the Polymega. Clearly, I don't have one. And I canceled my pre-order. But my point is that for those who wants that seamless retro experience, it's not exactly something you get with the Mister. I know that if anyone would be interested in one, I would help them out, set it up. It's I love doing that. I've modded consoles, software modded consoles. I mean, God, IPS panel, Game Boy Advance here with a custom white shell, DSi with the Twilight menu. I mean, I'm surrounded in it actually. My PS2 over there is modded with the OPL and the free McBoot. Like, I've got that, man. But again, not everyone knows how to do that stuff, and I love it when friends ask me, like, hey, you know, I'm interested in this. Can you help me set this up? And I'm just like, absolutely, I'll do that. So I just wanted to get that out of the way. The reason I say that is just because I want to be as neutral as possible about that stuff. Because you'll get those people that are just like, oh, you know, you bought, a console. You could just get a Raspberry Pi and have all these things. It's like, again, not everyone wants a fucking project. It's just as simple as that. So yeah. And anyway, so we got Tekken 2 here. I played the shit out of this, as probably many kids did back then. I don't remember who I played a lot as. I think I played a lot as... I played as Law a lot. And I think June was my next one. I don't know what outfit I picked. I know if you press X or square... Oh, okay, I got his real one. I used to spam the, that one over and over again. It worked most of the time. And this is one of those games where, like, the difficulty gets harder as the game keeps going with characters. It's like, well, yeah, obviously, that's what a video game is. No, like, specifically, the AI gets stupid good. Like, even if you set it to easy, like, eventually it becomes more like normal by the time you're fighting Kazuya or something. I'm not saying it's the hardest thing ever, but, like, it's one of those things where you can tell that, like, they programmed the AI to get, like, smart and adapt to your tricks or something. I could be totally wrong, but that's what it felt like to me as a kid. You win. Anyway, I played so much of that I don't want to play it anymore. So, any suggestions, throw them out here. So far, I've been going on an hour and a half. Maybe we'll make this a two and a half hour thing. I hope this covers some stuff for a lot of people. Get some games that they've wanted to test out. I've tested quite a few so far. Let's start from the bottom up. So I've got Xenogears, Wipeout 3. Wipeout 3, I tried, it looked good. Wild Arms 2, Vandal Hearts, Valkyrie Profile. I remember I played the intro to Vagrant Story last night. That was good. We've got Tomba. Tomba used to not be playable at all. I got to the main screen and just fine. But I didn't get into the gameplay. Let's see. Mob Racer or NFS2, Need for Speed 2. I don't have Need for Speed 2 or Motor Racer. I apologize. I have... What racing games do I have on here? I have Ridge Racer. Well, I can show you what happens when I play Ridge Racer 4. I don't think it works, actually. We'll give it a shot, though. But yeah, I just naturally like tinkering stuff, so this is cool to me. I hope this video answers any questions anyone has about this. Again, I'm not like this arbiter of knowledge here when it comes to this stuff. But I can definitely look up a YouTube tutorial and do some research, and that's what led me to all this stuff in general. So as you can see, Ridge Racer 4, I don't think it's 4, but it's called R4, doesn't even start. So that's another one that doesn't work. And let's go here. So we'll try the original Ridge Racer. So once I do that, I think at some point I want to show you guys a couple things too for anyone that has a Mister. I love how, like, the beginning of these games, at least Namco games, you can play a little bit of these older games while it's loading. Anyway, I want to do something at the end of this to show some of the setup for it. It's not anything in depth, but some things some people haven't seen, because I think I knew one guy, I think it's Juliet actually, on YouTube. He said he tried one of the nightly cores, but didn't really get too much going for it. I think that's what he said. But maybe this will shed some light on how to get that set up. So, but or at least kind of a cheat code way of doing it. So I don't know if I have the music up on here. Sure. Ridge Racer is definitely a classic arcade game. It was one of the first few PlayStation games. I think it was a launch title. It definitely shows its age. And when you hit stuff, it's so unrealistic. It's just bunk. But again, it's a video game. And that's to be expected of games of this era. And this is more of an arcade racer. It's not a Gran Turismo. Which I did put that on here as well. I haven't tested that one yet either. As you can see, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. So we'll try something else. Let's see. What would be another good one to try out? I know Crash Bandicoot Warped worked out pretty well. Dead or Alive sort of works. I'll show you that. That one's kind of funny. Because I never actually played the first one. But as people know, what makes Dead or Alive very popular. Not popular, but what people know about Dead or Alive is that boob physics. And boy, oh boy, the first one did it pretty poorly. It's actually quite funny. So let's go to training. And yeah, you'll guys see what happens here. It's technically playable, but yeah, so you see these wonderful scan lines. You see your tits. Jesus Christ. But yeah, as you can see, it's like when you win in solitaire. It's ridiculous. It doesn't look so good. Amusing. Not exactly cycle accurate. But, you know, we're getting there. Robert is getting there. Yeah, and there's no music right now either, but I wonder if that's just because it's training mode. I have no idea. But yeah, looks wonderful. So, let's try a couple more here. Einhander. Yeah, let's try Einhander. I really like the music to that one. We'll jam out to some Einhander. Yeah, the reason I wanted to cover all of this, I don't know if I said this earlier, is just because PlayStation was one of my personal favorite consoles, right next to Super Nintendo and the Super Famicom. So it's it makes me really happy that I can play this lag-free with save states, mind there you, was a on time the MiSTer. So, in the era and it's so damn chaos, close right now.
When the Earth and the Moon were at war with each other.
Einhander is one of those games that is like, when I checked it like in 2019, it was like $350, so I can only imagine it's $600 now. Okay. I'm sorry I didn't press start within 5 seconds. There we go. I never know which one is like the cool one. Okay, so special steam-powered fighter uses 2 gun pods simultaneously, equip both guns differently. Not sure what we're doing. Dig me if there was that. Not exactly sure what the plot of this one is. And then eventually I get weapon pickups. I think Einhander is like German for like arm or hand or something, and that's because you've got like a grappling hook on this thing. Yeah, so that's cool. Oh shit. I got fucked right there. Oopsie. The sound director did such a good job with this one. Very Blade Runner-esque. I feel like Japan was super obsessed with that. I don't know why I said I feel like I know that's the case. Oh shit, I can use both upgrades at the same time, that rules. Hello. Oh man. So looks like this game is doing well so far. Really well. Yeah, I think you guys get the point. I'm quite impressed with this one. All right. So, and I added some other stuff on here too I haven't tried yet before. Front Mission 3 was a big one for me as a kid. Harmful Park, if you've seen JonTron videos from like forever ago, he covered some weird shooters. That's one of them. I never really messed with In the Hunt. That's the same guys who made Metal Slug eventually. And I love Metal Slug. So I think we'll, you know what, why don't we, let's find a OG. How about like Crash Bandicoot or something? I think that's something that people would appreciate. So we'll play a Crash Bandicoot level. And then we'll kind of wrap things up here. So
Sony Computer Entertainment America presents.
Turn that down a little bit.
A Universal Interactive Studios production. A game created and developed by Naughty Dog.
All right. But again, like, so far, it's only been a handful of games that have given me problems.
Actually, I lied. So after this, I'll show you exactly, like, the games that will have glitches and stuff. I mean, now, you saw that with Dead or Alive. You get my point. So we'll make this the last thing. And then I want to show anyone that has a Mr. The little trick here.
Crash, crash.
Skip that. I played these ones as a lot as a kid. I'm sure a lot of you have as well. It's a classic. You know, speaking of that, I know they remastered this. Vicarious Visions, I think, is their name. They did. They're the ones that were responsible for the Tony Hawk 1 and 2 remaster as well. I think they do a good job. I just think that there's, like, some design decisions in terms of character designs that's a little off, but, like, nothing too bad. I do remember, though, that the hitboxes in this are box-shaped, while the new one is pill-shaped. So there's, like, footage of the level in the first Crash Bandicoot, the bridge that's like with the turtles that are kind of shitty. Like when you're on the tightrope and you jump on it, at least in the original, you kind of stay on there because you're box shaped. But if you do that in the new one and you're pill shaped, you slowly slide off. And it's not just things like that. You'll slide off the edges of things because of the pill shape, as opposed to the box shape where you could be at the edge of a corner and nothing really happens. So, yeah, I don't know. It's an interesting choice. But yeah, so far, this looks good. Music's all intact and everything. I also learned something today after... It took me a while to set this up. Way longer than I anticipated. And that's because I couldn't figure out... Because I'm using a capture card that uses a 3.0 USB. And I had other devices plugged in the USB ports in general. And, like, the game would work, but, like... Recording the game would work, but, like, I couldn't see an image of me, or it would work in reverse. And, or sometimes the audio would get out, and I didn't understand what the hell was going on. Because I put it to my laptop, and it was just fine when I tested OBS on my laptop. But, what was happening is that I had too much shit in the 3.0 ports. And they share bandwidth. So some of you might be like, duh. But for me, I was just like, wow, I spent like 2 hours trying to figure this out, and it was just because I had too much other shit in there. So I'm glad I solved it, though. It was frustrating at the time, but everything's good now. But as you can see, Crash Bandicoot is, it's working. Very well, in fact. So I have a feeling, as I said this to my girlfriend, is that I feel like this core will be finished in the next couple months, but I'm starting to think maybe 2 months max. I could be wrong. I don't want to overpromise anything, but at the speed that Robert Peep has been going, I mean, this is insane. The fact that that it's this good already. So. That being said, that's not what I want. That being said, it makes me wonder what the Saturn core and when that's coming out. I think that will take longer because the Sega Saturn had two CPUs, and that might be hard to program. I mean, even software emulation is hit and miss with that. If you haven't noticed, my background is the same as my layout on the stream here. If you can't tell, I like that. That's from The Last Blade, which is a Neo Geo fighting game. Anyway, so here's the trick, guys. I've had some people
or at least I've heard a couple people, by a couple I mean just one, I think it was Juliet that mentioned something about how he got the core on here, but it doesn't like run that well. I think that's what he said. I don't want to put words in his mouth. This is what you do when you go to your scripts, and you can add the script onto the device. You can do it either via throwing your SD card in the computer or using an FTP client. And let me see if, yeah, update PSX. In fact, I'll do it right in front of you guys. And what that does is it updates the recent, it updates the current core you have of the PSX core to the most recent version. In fact, I'm going to update this, and I don't think anything will change, but if it does, we'll test out another game. So, BIOS ROM has been found. Nothing to do here. Now it's reading, removing previous version, adding new version. All done. Have fun. Doesn't tell me if that's a new one. I don't remember if that's the case, but we'll test it out. So, why don't we do that? And we'll go to a game that I know has trouble. So maybe let's try Rayman. I want Rayman to work. Rayman is a pretty game, if you remember the first Rayman. Oh, whoop. There we go. We'll see how this goes. Oh, okay. Is it there? You go. Last time it was stuck on this logo, so I don't think it's going to do anything personally. I don't think it's going to do anything. I think it's all done. But that being said, I'm going to put it on Street Fighter EX. And maybe I'll play a little bit of that, and that will be the end of it. So I know there's a couple people on here. Throw out some questions if you have any. Throw out some commentary if you'd like. I'm gonna ease it down now. And I'm gonna do a couple of the missions. I think you guys would find that entertaining. It's something I'm pretty good at. Right. So far, I mean, I've been really happy about is Street Fighter EX, admittedly. I mean, it's pretty much fucking perfect. Sure. We'll start with good old Ryu. I am renting Rayman from Blockbuster years old. Oh shit. Yeah. Yep. I went to my neighbor's house to play Rayman with him years old. And the reason I like this game is just because you can combine specials. I'm sure I'll do a mission where you're gonna see that. Oop. So I know that stuff looks easy, where it's like, oh, just press those buttons. It's like, it's timed. You have to do it at the right time. It's interesting. A nice way of putting it. This
this one's not. I mean, sometimes I can get it in the first couple tries, sometimes it takes me a second. There we go. This one's kind of lame too. Maybe I can trick it. I almost had it. There we go. That one's goofy. Just based on the like arrow movements for that one. Yes! That's what I mean by comboing these tricks. Holy shit. Okay, jumping heavy kick, crouching medium punch, crouching medium kick, Hadouken, shoot you. Okay. I've done, like, I've completed some of these missions in its entirety. But that doesn't mean it doesn't take me a while, so some of these last ones are rough. Character. I got most of them. Good enough. See, the throw is like side hard punch, so you can easily grapple them when you're trying to do a special. It's very annoying. I can literally do this all the time. Of course, now is when I have an issue. Okay. Yeah, well, let's try a different controller. If I can't do it in the next couple, I'll just move on. It'll get sad otherwise. Awesome. One's a little difficult. I think it's the last one though, and it seems like, well, you just did a six combo one, how's this one hard? It's because of the button placement, that's why. You know what, we'll just move on. But I think this is where I'll end it, actually. I'm gonna, let me do this too though, because I really like putting it on this mode. So I like putting it on watch, have it play in the background. So what did we learn today? We learned that Robert Peep knows what he's doing. more or less, Robert Peep, I'm very happy with the progress that he has done on this so far. A lot of people are. The fact that I can play this in the state that it is absolutely amazing. Go support his project if you're interested. If you have the Mister, I could see why you would want to do that. For those who don't have a Mister, you know, obviously you don't give a shit, so fair enough. But maybe what this can do for you guys is tell you, or at least spark an interest in the Mister project in general. You know, I'm not gonna lie to you, it's pretty expensive. I'm not endorsed by anyone, obviously. I have a very low viewership right now. I'd like to change that. But that being said, when DE 10 nanos are back on the market and they're not dog shit expensive, this might be something for you, especially with the save states enabled in this, especially with cores always like being developed for. I mean, they have the Atari Lynx compatibility. It's like, who plays that? Like, fair enough. But the fact that they have that is bizarre to me. So let me tell you my personal favorite things on the Mister currently. It's Super Nintendo, it's Sega Genesis, it's CPS2, which is the Capcom arcade games. I know CPS1 is a fond memory that had like Ghosts and Goblins and stuff like that. I know a lot of people like that. But CPS2 has a special place in my heart because I love all the fighting games, if you can't tell. I love all, or that way, actually. My TV's here, but what you're seeing is right here. Anyway, huge fan of the arcades games in the mid-90s, so Neo Geo's huge for me, King of Fighters, Metal Slug, all that kind of stuff. They're adding PlayStation. Like, that's just the cherry on the cake. The cherry on the ice cream, so to speak. And the Sega Saturn core is being developed for. Now, that's probably going to be a little bit slower, but it's made some good progress in the year that I've been following them. If I had my projections on the PlayStation core, I said it earlier, I think give it a couple more months, maybe two tops. I could be wrong, but at the pace, it's just, I wouldn't be surprised, okay? So, longevity for Sega Saturn is responsible for such classics like Sonic R Racing. No, I'm just kidding. That game sucked. But the music fucking slaps, though. They had games like... some of you retro guys will know what I'm talking about. Panzer Dragoon. Why can't I think of anything right now? Like, they have a really rare one, Magic Knight Ray Earth. That game's, like, worth, like, $1,000 now. It's like... Well, you have another option now. I'm not going to say how or why, but you don't have to spend $1,000 for that. Let's just say that, if that core comes out. And what else? It had Sonic CD, or not Sonic CD. Jeez, why can't I think of it? They had Snatcher on it. Good lord. I'm just drawing a blank for some damn reason. Panzer Dragoon, Guardian Heroes. I mean, there's a there like a Shining Force. There's like that really rare Panzer Dragoon game. Anyway, that game has a few classics on there. Apparently, it has the best version of Street Fighter Alpha 3. Like I said previously, if anyone was wondering why I didn't put like Marvel vs. Capcom, SNK vs. Capcom, or not SNK, excuse me, Marvel vs. Capcom, Marvel vs. X-Men, Marvel vs. Street Fighter. Not Marvel, but jeez, I can't get it. Street Fighter versus Capcom versus Marvel, Marvel Super Heroes versus Street Fighter. You get my point. That all that shit, the X-Men. The reason I didn't put it on the PlayStation Core on this one is because CPS2 is already supported, which is the better way of playing it. It's already supported on this, so you can get the best arcade perfect versions of your favorite CPS2 games, of your favorite Capcom fighting games. But the Street Fighter 3 on the PlayStation, it's good, but I'd rather play the CPS2 one. However, if the Sega Saturn core comes out, again, I was told that the Street Fighter Alpha 3, the best way to play it is on the Saturn just because of all the different options. So we will see when I get that opportunity. Oh yeah, Grandia is also on there as well. It's an RPG. But anyway, if I had a project for the Sega Saturn, I think that core will come late this year or early next year. That's my guess, but I could be wrong here. Anyway, let's look at some what some people have said. Mr. Mega Fan said Popful Mail. That's another Sega Saturn classic. Yeah, they had a lot of shoot 'em ups. Oh God, Fighting Vipers, Virtua Fighter 2. Jesus Christ, what is wrong with me? I don't know what. Like, it's like, I just, Sega Rally, I don't know what was wrong with me, but, like, I just blocked out the classics and just could only remember the obscure ones. It's just so silly. The Last Bronx. Anyway. But, yeah, so, I think this is where I'll end it. I appreciate anyone that stopped by. Hopefully, I've got a lot of games on here that are covered that anyone... Like, because this will be on YouTube, so, like, if anyone wants to see what games are on here, what's supported so far, this is a good reference. So, yeah. Anyway, if you like my stuff, please subscribe to my channel. If you like it enough, go ahead and to my Patreon and support my Patreon. For any of you MiSTer users, go ahead and support Robert Peep over here. And this is where I'm going to sign off. Thanks, guys, and have an excellent week. Bye-bye.